Hi, grade 2! Good morning! Now, before we start with our math, with our lessons, let's sing God is Good All the Time. God is good all the time. Put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good all the time. In this darkest night, His light will shine. God is good all the time. If you're walking through the valley and the shadows all around, do not fear, He will guide you. He will keep you safe and sound. He has promised never leave you nor forsake you. And His word is true. God is good all the time. Put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good all the time. Through the darkest night, His light will shine. God is good. God is good all the time. We were sinners, so unworthy, still for us to choose to die. Fill us with His Holy Spirit, now we can stand and testify. With His love is everlasting, and His mercies, they will never end. God is good all the time. Put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good all the time. Through the darkest night, His light will shine. God is good. God is good all the time. God is good all the time. He put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good all the time. Through the darkest night, His light will shine. God is good. He is so good. God is good. He is so good. God is good. He is so good. All the time. Amen. God is good all the time. And all the time, God is good. Okay, now please close your eyes and let us pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for this day. Please help us and guide us as we have our lessons for today. Help us to understand it. And please be with us as we answer our book works for today. We are also praying for those who are sick. Please heal them, O Lord. And please forgive us in all of our sins. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay. Good morning, grade 2. Good morning. So now let's have our math. Okay. Let's continue our math lesson number 2. Today, we are now lesson number 2 and still multiplication, right? Okay, so now for our multiplication, let's have multiplication as equal jumps in a number. So you're gonna jump in equal number. Okay, so this one is skip counting. So to find out kasayaan si Mrs. Hernandez, she asked her pupils. Mrs. Hernandez divided her math class into 5 groups for an activity. And there are 2 pupils in each group. So how many pupils are there in the class of Mrs. Hernandez? So to find out the how many pupils are in Mrs. Hernandez's class, we can skip by 2. Okay, so let's start. So let's start skip counting by 2. 1, 2. So 2 here, 1, 2. Okay, and then it's 5 groups. Okay, let's see if there is 5 groups. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so 2, where did you get the 2? There. Times 5, where did you get the 5? Here, the skip. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the answer is 10. Where did you get the 10? There, the last number here. After ng last skip. Okay? So, let's have another example. So, look at this number line. Okay? So, what is the multiplication sentence? 1. Why 1? Because the first is skip, it lands in 1. Times 7. Why 7? Because he skips for 7 times. Let's count if it is really 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, it's 7. And the answer is 7. There, the last number. Okay, now on your, let's see if you can do it. So this one, what is the multiplication sentence? Ready? Think. Okay, so first one is 3. Where did we get the 3? There. Okay, next, what is times? What will be here? What numbers are here? Ready? Think. Say it. 8. Why 8? Where did you get? Where? How? What is? Why the our answer is 8? Okay. Again, how many times did we skip? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And what is the answer? Ready? Think. Say it. Correct. It is 24. Okay, another example. So what is the number multiplication sentence? Ready? Think. What is the first number here? Say it. Correct. It's number 2. There, oh, number 2. The first is skip. Saan nagland? Number 2. And then, what times? How many? What is the number there? Think. Say it. 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Correct. And the answer. What's the answer? 2 times 7 equals? Think. What is the answer? Say it. Correct. It is 14. Okay, now another example. What is the multiplication sentence for this one? Think. What is the first number? Say it. Correct. It is 4. Look, 4. Next, 4 times how many? Think. Say it. Correct. It's 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, what is the answer? Think. Say it. Correct. It is 16. Now, you, this time, no more practice. Get your book and open it on page 150. 150. 150. Okay, so let's see. Number 1, please write your answer. What is the first number here that you are going to write? Next, blank times blank here. Write your answer. And equals... yeah, the answer here. Okay, now let's go to number 2. Blank, what could be, what number here? What is supposed to be here? What number? Times, okay, here. And the equals, the answer. Okay, next, last one, number here. Blank times blank equals blank. So first blank, what number are you gonna write there? Okay, times, and then the answer. Okay, very good. Now let us proceed to our next way on how to get this time. You will be the one to do the skipping, yung gaganon. Okay? So it says here, 3 times 5 equals, what is the answer? So we need, we're gonna do to make the skips here. Okay? So 3. So we're gonna count 3. 1, 2, 3. So we will start here. 3. And then count, we need 5 skips, 5 jump, okay? 5 skips. So we got 1 already. Then let's see, 1, 2, 3, oh, so 6, 2. Okay, next. 1, 2, 3, oh, so 9. Dapat sa 9 natin, 3. Okay, next. We got 3 already. It says here, 5. Next, 1, 2, 3. There, 12. We have 4 now. And last one, 1, 2, 3, 15. So 3 times 5, 3 here. Where did you get the 3? Here, okay? Paano how can you make 3? 1, 2, 3. Okay, from 0, you're gonna count 1, 2, 3. So yun yung first mong skip. And then, second skip is you're gonna count again, 1, 2, 3. So that is your second skip. Count again, 1, 2, 3. That's your third skip. And then count again, 3, 1, 2, 3. That's your fourth skip. And the last skip is 1, 2, 3. Then the last skip, the fifth skip. So what is the number there? 3 times 5 equals 15. Okay? So you are going to do the skipping on your own. Okay, so let's see, get your book, open it on page 153. So first, from 0, count 1 to 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then yung first skip mo. You need to make 9. 9. Okay, go! And what is the answer? Make sure to write to do the skipping, okay? And write your answer. Okay, done? Now, let's go to number 2. Number 2. 3. Okay, start sa 3. First, skip sa 3. And then do it for 7 times. 7 times. Okay, now let's go to number 3. Number 3. Again, 3, but this time, you're gonna do it 8 times. Okay? Kanina, 7 times. Now, for the number 3, you're gonna do it for 8 times. Okay, and the last number, number 4, 5 times 7. Okay, by 5, skip up to 7 times. Skip by 5 for 7 times. Okay, go. Okay, very good. If you are not yet done, please pause the video. And then if you're finished, then you can play it. So for our next topic, it is about commutative property of multiplication. Remember the commutative property of addition? Okay, so it is also the same with our multiplication. So look here, we learned about the arrays, multiplication of arrays last time. So we have here box 5 rows, a box 8, box A, we have 5 rows of 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the rows of 6 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In a while, in box B, we have 6 rows by 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 by 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in our commutative property, 5 times 6 equals 30. And the commutative property of 5 times 6, 30 is equal to 6 times 5, 30. Okay? So the numbers we multiply are called factors. The 6 and the 5. The 5 and 6 are called factors. What is called? Correct. Factors. Now, the answer 30, we call it product. Okay? These are the factors. 6 and 5. And the number 30, the answer is called product. And the sign X means we use multiplication or we multiply. We say times for this one. 6 times 5 equals 30. And 5 times 6 equals 30. And we can write the multiplication in horizontal and vertical. So, commutative property of multiplication states that if you change the order of the factors, the numbers 6 and 5 or 5 and 6, the product is still the same. The product, the answer is still the same. So that is our commutative property. So look at this one. 5 times 6 equals 30. Or if we change it, 6 times 5, the answer is still 30. Okay, another example. 5 columns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 3 rows. 1, 2, 3. The answer is 15. 5 times 3. So here, the commutative property of 5 times 3 equals 15 is 3. It becomes 3 here. Nag-exchange. The 5 here, it goes to the second. And the 3 here, it goes to the first. But even though it exchanged, the answer is still the same. What? And that is the example of commutative property of multiplication. So now, let us try doing this. Okay, the arrays. How many columns? 2. How many rows? 4. 2 times 4. And then the commutative property is how many columns? You just exchange. Okay? 4 times 2. Okay, what about here? Can you please think for this one? Ready? Think. Okay, very good. 3 times 4 and the commutative property is 4 times 3. Okay, now look here because this is the one that you're gonna do to your book later. So it says here 2 rows of 3. 2 rows of 3. So you're gonna color 2 rows and in each row and in each column may tarang 3 rows. 1, 2, 3. And next 1, 2, 3. You're going to color it. So 2 times 3 equals, and then you're gonna count, the answer is 6. And the other one, the commutative property is 3 times 2 equals 6. Okay, again, 2 rows of 3, kasi later you will be the one to color. 2 rows of 3. So first row, 1. First column, 1, 2, 3. Next, 1, 2, 3. Meron tayong 1, 2. And then rows, 1, 2, 3. And then count, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The answer is 6. The all same here, but this time, magiging 3 rows. 1, 2, 3, and then 2 na lang siya. Magiging 3 columns and magiging 2 rows na lang siya. Okay, we exchange it. And we're making it into a commutative property. So now please get your book, open it on page 160. And get, or you can use your pencil to shade the, what's this? The table here, okay? Mga boxes. Okay, 4 rows. So, we are going to color 3 sa first Okay, four columns of three, of rows of three, four rows of three. So, tatlo, tatlo, tatlo hanggang apat na column. One, two, three, four, then one, two, three. Go, color it, and then count. How many? Okay, color it here also, color, and then count, and then write the answer. Okay, now let's go to number three. Four rows, o di, a while ago sabi three, ngayon two na lang. Four rows of two. Four rows of two. Go. Four columns and two rows. Next, two rows, two columns, but four rows. Okay, color, and then 4 times 2, the commutative property of 4 times 2 is 2 times 4. Then write your answer. So if you are not yet done, continue it before you proceed, okay? For our assignment, you need to study for our quiz tomorrow and take a picture of page 150, 160. So thank you everyone and see you tomorrow. Bye.